a number of viral outbreaks in recent years have raised concerns over a broader pandemic, including SARS in 2003, H1N1 in 2009, and H7N9 in 2013. And now the mysterious Wuhan coronavirus, with first case reported in December 2019. The situation is still fluid at present, the number of cases and fatalities on the rise. And all this happening just as China heads into its week-long Chinese Lunar New Year holiday, a peak travel season. Joining us now from Singapore to talk about the macro implications of the Wuhan coronavirus and its spread, Fitch Solutions, Sakshi Sika. Sakshi, good morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Now, Sakshi, how vulnerable are Asian economies to outbreaks of infectious diseases?
Right. So first, I will look at the Chinese economy. And of course, the spread of the virus is a downside risk to the Chinese economy. Of course, there are fears of another SARS-like outbreak. And if we consider the economic impact of SARS, for example, it had costed the Chinese economy around $25 billion and had slashed around 1 to 2% from the country's GDP. Then, of course, we at Fitch Solutions believe that the new virus will unlikely have the same negative impact on the economy as SARS did in 2003, given the scope of the epidemic and China's ability to effectively contain the virus from further spreading. But as you mentioned, as many Chinese are expected to travel abroad during the Lunar New Year holiday, infections could become rampant in Asian nations. And the worst affected countries are likely to be the most dependent on the Chinese tourist spending. So in addition to China itself, of course, there's Hong Kong, which stands as the most exposed. Thailand and Vietnam are also vulnerable.
Mm-hmm. What about the Philippines, Sakshi? Do you see the Philippines also feeling the impact from this, considering Chinese tourists are one of our biggest sources of dollars from tourist receipts?
Right. So for now, the impact on Philippines we see as minimal because that many cases haven't been reported in Philippines. So for now, Philippines, we see the impact as being low.
Okay, now the World Health Organization actually says that for now, this Wuhan coronavirus remains a local Chinese emergency. Do you think that countries in general are better equipped to handle this today? I mean, when you look at China, how advanced would you say is the country in terms of monitoring, curing, and preventing outbreaks like this, or in terms of health technology?
Right, so Chinese authorities' response to the pneumonia outbreak has been much faster, more decisive and open in contrast to SARS. The healthcare system currently in China and the hospitals are also far better prepared with improved surveillance systems, state-of-the-art medical facilities. And our clients have also said that in the months since the outbreak emerged, Chinese authorities have already been efficient in identifying cases, sequencing the genome as well as releasing it to the scientific community so that vaccine development can take place. That said, of course, given the travel patterns and the increased testing that we see, more cases of the virus should be expected in other parts of China and also in other countries in the coming days.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that the fact that this particular virus started in China, a highly populated country, which is also going into a break where about 3 billion journeys are expected to be made during this holiday season, do you think it makes it worse that this started in China?
That's right. Definitely, it couldn't have come at a worse time. But what we see is that in various airports in China and other Asian countries as well, medical staff has already been stationed alongside biosecurity staff to screen and conduct an initial diagnosis of people who, for example, are exhibiting flu-like symptoms. And if necessary, they are then escorted to the hospital for further testing. And of course, Chinese authorities have also sealed off cities like Wuhan on Thursday, suspending all flights and trains out of the city and telling residents they could not leave without a special reason. So they have started taking a lot of measures.
Mm-hmm. Sisha, do you see any short-term winners or losers in this sort of scenario? Specific companies perhaps in China or in other parts of ASEAN, including the Philippines?
Right, yes. So a growing number of Chinese listed companies, we believe, ranging from biotech firms who have large investments in vaccine, local drug makers, mask producers, thermometer manufacturers, will participate or already are participating in the government-led fight against the virus. So what we've seen is that the shares of domestic pharma companies, for instance, surged by about 10% as China released new cases on Monday, and also the healthcare section in the MSCI index also rose. But of course, if you look at the losers, the travel, tourism, retail, luxury goods market will be affected on concerns that the virus will cause people not to travel and cancel trips during the Chinese New Year and stay home, which could be, you know, it's the Chinese New Year is the peak travel and spending week for China's consumers. And the virus has also started impacting airline and hotel operator stock prices.
Mm-hmm. Do you think, Sakshi, that the markets have fully priced this in?
So right now, the investors are very anxious. And like what we saw when the Ebola outbreak happened, as well as when the Zika virus outbreak happened, the economic consequences only realized after the virus is contained. So we will have to wait and we can't speculate on that.
Mm-hmm. And how long does it usually take for these viruses to normalize before activity goes back to normal, based on historical experience?
Right. So as you mentioned that, you know, despite the spread of the new coronavirus, the WHO has held off on recommending a public health emergency of international concern, because right now a lot of the information is still being gathered on the ground and the authorities are still learning about the virus and the extent of human to human transmission. So if in a scenario where the virus mutates, then that's when the WHO might classify this coronavirus outbreak as a public health emergency, because that's when the epidemic actually happens. So if that happens, then it can take 3 to 4 months to actually control the virus. But if the virus doesn't mutate, then it can be controlled within 2 to 3 months.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Sakshi, for joining us this morning.
Thank you so much.